gonna demonstrate putting together the SBS sampling system. We start off with the lead sampling section. And I would use a non-adhesive Teflon tape to seal it off and protect the threads while it's in use. This is the body section. It has two pieces so that it could be used for a 2-foot sampler as well. We're gonna put together a 4-foot. There's a liner. The liner has a hole and use that on the top end. On the bottom, you have an internal drive tip and an external drive tip. The internal rod is 2-piece. You place it on to the lead tip. Place it into the external drive tip so that it's cone, almost a perfect cone or pyramid. On the bottom, you use a white core catcher and you put it with the dome upwards towards the top of the sampler. Take the second piece of the internal rod. Again, I would use non-adhesive Teflon tape to protect the threads and keep water or contamination from going inside. On the top, use a metal catcher. Again, dome up. It's down, or into it, the dome is upwards. Want to make sure that the tip stays timed out so that it's a cone on the end. Okay. Now that we have it assembled, we've checked the depth of water and we're going to put a 3-foot internal and external. Once it's together, we're going to put the thread protector cap on. It'll protect the threads and keep the timing set for the internal as you're driving it to the depth you want to sample. If you can help me here, we're going to lower it to depth, drive it in 6 inches or 1 foot, and then collect the sample. So go ahead and I'll lower this down. I don't want to put any pressure on the tip because it'll lift it. So before I lower it to the bottom, we'll put the... Now we're gonna drive it about 6 inches, 6 or 8 inches, and pull the center. So go ahead. Remove the thread protector cap and put on the T-handle. Now the O-rings on the internal tip as you drive it in, they'll swell or expand, and it's usually harder for it to be removed. So the T-handle allows you to get some leverage and the grip and pull it out. We'll pull the center rod out. Go ahead and take this. Go ahead and push it off. With that, we'll take the slide hammer. We've now removed the internal tip, and when we take it apart, I'll show you that it's inside the chamber at the top. We're now going to drive it in about a foot or so and collect the sample. On this, we're gonna use and do a back hammering on it. The best thing to do when you back hammer is put Teflon tape on the threads. There's also a removal jack. If it doesn't back hammer and come out very easy, it's better to use the removal jack. You would use this type of pull cap on it and pull it out that way. It's much better on the sampling or on the thread connections, and it keeps from the sample from being jarred out. This time we're going to try to backhammer it out. We didn't have Teflon for this, but we recommend it. Go ahead and pull it up there, Harry. Depending on the type of sediment that you have, if it's just silt and organic, it can kind of dissolve. You don't get a full recovery. We're going to go ahead and pull this off. This is the top chamber that I was referring to. The tip is removed from the center rods and is in this chamber. This catcher is in there to keep the tip, once it's removed, from falling back down and preventing sediment from coming up into the liner. Some sediments or silts or sands that come in, it can lock the liner and it's difficult to remove. There's a hole in the liner that you can get with this hook removal tool, and you can pull the sample out. I'm not sure what sample is in there, but I'll go ahead and remove it to keep from losing it. Lay it down when you remove it. And we pushed it in about a foot. We got about a foot of sample. A little bit less than a foot, but you do get some compaction. This was very soft material, and some of it did dissolve. I could tell as we were pulling the sampler out of the water. But then we would prepare it that way, cut off the void, and send it out for a sample. So we drove about a foot, and that's about a sample that we got. And we skipped the upper. We know for certain that what's in here was collected from the sediment below the upper 8 inches or so. So we've got a good sample.